I went on tour for the Natec network at InterSolar to ask the partners one important question. What's new? Okay, Frank, we're here again in Munich. Last year we were here at SolarEdge, and I want to ask you, what's new?
Yeah, almost everything is new.
Everything?
I have 10 new things for you. So we transitioned from a P-series optimizer to an S-series optimizer, meaning that the S-series is actually measuring the temperature on the connectors to understand if there's any degradation in the connection, worsening, and then we can prematurely switch off the system to prevent any issues.
Previously, you could already do that, but now you can do it per connector.
Yeah, previously we did it on string level, and now we do it on every connector.
Secondly, the SolarEdge Home Hub Inverter.
They are compatible with the storage, of course. This is by default, but we're also now making them compatible with the storage system with backup.
Which means if the grid fails, I will just continue my enjoyable life.
Many people always say, I have solar panels, but when the grid fails, I have nothing.
No,
this is no longer the case. So with the backup interface, we can actually isolate the home from the electricity grid, because if the grid fails and you start producing energy, you give all the energy to the neighbors. We don't want that.
Okay.
So you create your own mini island, and you're going to be producing energy for yourself.
Yeah, so the backup interface is supported by the hub inverter, and which also supports the battery?
Correct, yeah. It's a new 48-volt base battery. This is a three-phase hub inverter. We have also a single-phase hub inverter.
Yeah.
Single-phase has a different voltage level, so we have two different types of batteries.
Yeah.
But together we serve single-phase and the three-phase markets and make it complete.
What about the My SolarEdge app for the homeowners?
So we see it's more important that homeowners have control over the system. Previously we saw homeowners calling the installers for all the small things. So we're evolving the My SolarEdge application with more homeowner applications, control over the smart energy system, as I will show you in a bit.
Yeah.
And also time of use tables, which is becoming more relevant. You have negative energy tariffs in some countries now in Europe.
Yeah.
So homeowners need to be able to make those changes themselves. So
I really want to get my hand on that interface, because I mean it's getting better all the time.
So we're introducing the new SolarEdge Home Network, which is replacing all the RS-45 communication we have between batteries, between the smart devices. So RS-45 is no longer there as the primary connection, but in some cases you want to have RS-45, so we still allow it.
Okay.
But the primary connection is going to be the home network.
And all the devices now have support for this interface.
Yeah, correct. So we want to have everything in the same network. The inverters, the storage, the batteries, they also communicate on the home network. The new inline meters. The meter is not new, but it transitioned to wireless communication. And then to add that, we're completing the whole ecosystem with the hot water controller, which is transitioning to the wireless communication we just mentioned. And we're introducing also new devices and switches. But one of the important things is, why do we need to get control over loads? So if you have a backup system, and the backup system is consuming, let's say, 5,000 watts, or the home is consuming 5,000 watts, and the backup system can only provide, hypothetically, two. If you transition into a backup state, the system cannot provide enough energy and it will trip. So we have two things which are important: protecting the system from overload on an on-grid scenario, and avoiding an overload during a backup scenario. So now we have control over appliances, so we can control the consumption. And when we hit those levels, we switch off the devices and avoid that happening.
And here we have also the charger, which also is intelligently managed.
So we have the charger, which has, of course, the input limitations. It's a single phase or a three phase charger, and it's also capable of being charged by access PV. So we have a priority list. You can prioritize all the devices based on what you want to do. And the new dry contact switch also is capable of controlling heat pumps with the SG Ready protocol, smart grid ready protocol, that allows you to control and minimize and set heat pumps into overdrive if you have enough access speed.
Some people still are on the single phase. Do you have something for them too?
Yeah, we have the single phase energy up inverter.
Okay, let's see at the single phase one. The box looks still the same.
The box is the same. Yeah, I call it an inverter. It's no longer a box.
Yeah.
But the bottom section has everything inside. So the wireless communication protocol is also built in. So out of the box, the inverter can communicate the new wireless home network. And this inverter also supports backup.
Okay.
So basically, if you have the backup interface, your main AC goes to the backup interface, comes to the main AC panel. The inverter is connected to the main AC panel if you want to do whole home backup or partial home backup, depending on what the need is, and that's it.
Okay, so you have backup, you have wireless, and you have more intelligence, and you have batteries. 10 things in 5 minutes. Thank you very much, Frank.
You're welcome.